Trent Kirby from ElectroSport explains stators and regulator rectifiers.
Kyle Bradshaw from Cruiser Customizing here with Trent from ElectroSport. In an earlier session, we went over all of your product offerings, and you guys have a vast collection of items that are available for cruiser, sport, dirt, you name it. Today, we want to dig into stators. If you could give us a little bit of background on a stator, what exactly it does, what are the features and benefits of your stators, what they offer over OEM, that would be a huge help to us here at Cruiser Customizing.
Yeah, not a problem at all. The biggest difference between this and OEM visually by looking at it is just the blue coating that we use over the copper wires. The grommet's the same, the connector's the same. Basically what this blue coating is an epoxy coating to help dissipate heat. And under this coating is a bunch of copper wires. Our copper wires that we use, for example, on this Goldwing stator is wound with a thicker gauge to produce more output and create less of a resistance on the coil.
See, a lot of these have stock connectors, and this one here has three bare wires. Do most of the units come with stock connectors that just plug and play, or do you have to do something with the wires? Solder them, splice them? How do you install a stator?
A lot of the stators that we have are plug and play. The ones that are not, we are quickly working on getting the grommets and connectors to make them plug and play.
Question for you. This spins around in oil, right?
The stator itself is actually stationary. The flywheel is what spins over this unit. What you do is there's five bolt holes. Three of these bolt holes are going to mount to your side case cover. Your grommet gets pushed into the cover and the wires just simply plug into the OEM wiring harness. This is what actually sits in the flywheel itself, which is what's creating the electrical current.
I know the stator is great to replace if you're going to be adding additional light, anything electrical that you're going to be pulling off of the motorcycle. A new stator is definitely the way to go. Now, how do you know if you need a new stator if you're just running a bike that you have never had an issue with?
If you're going down the road and your battery just quits and your bike just won't start, more than likely there's an electrical issue going on. It could either be the stator, regulator, or battery. The best way to check it is definitely keep an eye on it, check the current that's coming out of your stator to make sure that's good. If it's below what the recommended service manual is, I would definitely look at replacing that as soon as possible because it's on its way to failing.
So in recap, the basic differences here, the dirt bike stators are going to allow you to run headlights, taillights, turn signals off of a motorcycle that didn't typically have that to begin with.
That's correct.
Then we've got the street stators that are going to be more generic plug and play for the OEM.
Part 2.
Kyle Bradshaw from Cruiser Customizing here with Trent from ElectroSport, who's going to teach us a little bit about the regulator rectifier. So this is an interesting component. It pretty much is plug and play on most applications. When do you know that you need a new regulator rectifier?
You'll know if you'll need a regulator rectifier either when your battery boils over or if you've got a multimeter on your bike and you either have a voltage surge of over 14.5 volts or if you're not charging, which would be 12.3 volts.
So what you're saying is the regulator rectifier can fail either direction. Either it's not allowing enough current to go to your battery, or you're sending so much current to the battery that your battery is boiling and exploding?
That's correct. If your bike is undercharging, typically the rectifier side of the regulator rectifier has failed, and if the motorcycle is overcharging, the regulator side has failed. But because the units are all one piece, you have to replace the whole unit.
So if I had a regulator rectifier fail on my motorcycle, could I replace it with your unit, or would I have to put your stator in it before I replaced it with your regular rectifier?
With our regulator rectifiers, you can replace them with your OEM unit. If your Kawasaki one failed, you can replace it with our unit, and you wouldn't have to upgrade the stator. Internally, they're pretty much the same as an OEM, just with higher amperage diodes and higher temperature solder. And internally, the circuit board is a lot beefier than the OEM, but they're completely compatible with OEM stators as well.
The price of the OEM versus the price of yours. You guys are using upgraded connectors, upgraded circuit boards, upgraded wiring, but the cost of your units is roughly half the cost of the OEM. So Trent, working from the top down, the stator produces the power, but it produces it at AC. It then transfers it to the regulator rectifier that then transfers that power from AC to DC because the motorcycle runs off of DC.
That's correct.
And then the regulator part of the regulator rectifier then regulates the amount of that power that then gets put to the battery so you stay within the legal limits.
That's correct.
Sounds great. Stators and regulator rectifiers explained by Trent Kirby. Thank you for watching this week's Cruiser Customizing Tip of the Week. Until next week, take care and ride safe.